Now there's nowhere to hide since you pushed my life aside. I'm out of my head, hopelessly devoted.
And I was running far away. Would I run off the wall someday? Nobody knows, nobody knows. And I was dancing in the rain. I felt alive and I can't complain. But no, take me home, take me home where I belong.
So I've received several comments recently saying that I buy my soaps from Alibaba.com in bulk and then I just cut them up and sell them to people and I'm a complete scam. So to address the rumors, this is not true. I do in fact make my soap by hand. I honestly just never thought that these soap making videos were very interesting, which is why I never really posted any videos of them. But here you go. This is me making a batch of oatmeal and honey soap. I put bubble wrap on the bottom to create this fun honeycomb design, and I honestly find it really satisfying to remove the bubble wrap after it's done setting. This is actually one of my first ever soaps to create, and I love it. I've been told that it helps with acne scars, and the honey just creates this beautiful lather whenever you use it. It also smells really good, and yeah, it's great for your skin. Here is me cutting the bars. I know they're not perfect, but I don't have a professional soap cutter, and I kind of feel like it adds a personal touch. Each bar is slightly different, and here's the finished product. These are my sample size bars, in case you're wondering.
I know this one's going to be deceiving. It doesn't look like much.
You know what she said to me? She said,
ooh, looks like larva.
Kobe. Oh my god, it's fucking...
It's not the most flattering angle for you guys. No way! That was very close too.
Yes! What?
This is one of my favorite creations. Starts with the bass and the lizard's body. Psh, psh. You know the drill, slipping and scoring, then squishing. Then brushing. I really wanted to have its tail hanging off some fungi, so that's what I'm doing here. Eye sockets and eyeballs, which you may notice are gonna change throughout the video because I'm indecisive. Then I cut open his mouth. Macaroni noodles or arms, you decide. By the way, I do sell my work, and the best way to stay updated is by following me on my Instagram. Then comes my favorite part, which is adding on all the little mushrooms. Sculpting mushrooms is so meditative and calming, I love it. Then the finishing touches of moss. This part is pretty relaxing too. All done. And there it is. I love this one so much. If you have any more animal suggestions, leave a comment and I may make it.
These are unbelievably satisfying. Thank you.